Here is a cross-sectional view of a common shower pan in the Pacific Northwest. This is a simplified model of the shower at my house. Here is the drain. Now, suppose I make a cross-sectional cut in this direction through the drain. Looking at it horizontally gives us the cross-sectional view of the shower pan. On the left is the wall, and on the right we have a small curb. Most houses in the Pacific Northwest are wooden structure. The bottom layer is the subfloor, which is installed on these horizontal beams called joists. And for the wall, these vertical beams are studs. Now back to our cross-sectional view. On the left is the stud. Here is the subfloor. And underneath are the joists. This pipe is the drain pipe. To be able to access the drain pipe, a hole needs to be cut on the subfloor, which is why you are seeing this disconnect here. First, a pipe fitting is required to connect to the drain pipe. This fitting is secured to the subfloor with screws, like so. Okay, this fitting is now connected to the drain pipe. Next, a mixture of cement and sand is poured around this drain fitting, creating a sloped base. This base is called a pre-slope. The slope is typically 2 to 3 degrees. On top of the pre-slope, a waterproof layer is needed. A very common method is to use a membrane made from PVC. This membrane is commonly called shower pan liner. This liner needs to cover the entire bathroom floor and the walls. Since this is a cross-sectional view, the liner is shown as disconnected here for the drain. But from the top view, it's a single continuous sheet. The liner goes up on the left side and wraps around on the right for waterproofing. For the wall side, like what we have on the left, the liner needs to run up at least 6 inches. And for the curb side, the liner wraps all the way around it. Waterproof adhesive is applied between the liner and the bottom drain fitting. Then a mating drain fitting from the top sandwiches the liner in the middle. And of course, waterproof adhesive is applied on the top area as well. The top drain fitting is secured to the one below using screws. The next step is to add fiber cement board. Most fiber cement boards require not to be placed directly on the shower pan liner, but rather there should be a gap between the fiber cement and the liner. The size of this gap varies with different boards, but it's usually at least 1/4 inch. Before making the top layer mortar bed, make sure to tighten the upper drain. On the side of this drain, there are small holes indicated by the light blue area. Surrounding the small holes, place some small pebbles or gravel. This creates what's called weep holes. I'll explain later on why this is needed. Once the pebbles are in place, use mortar to create a sloped surface. And this is the top layer mortar bed. Next, apply waterproofing layer onto the fiber cement board. But before doing that, make sure to apply some thinset along with mesh tape to cover all of the gaps or cracks on the fiber cement board. For waterproofing layer, it is crucial to note that the waterproofing layer only needs to cover the wall and a small portion of the joint between the fiber cement board and the mortar bed. Never, again, never cover the entire mortar bed with waterproofing material. I'll explain the reason in later portion of this video. This is the waterproof coating. A common product people use is RedGard. See, the waterproof coating only covers the wall and the tiny area where the wall meets the bed. For corners, I recommend apply mesh fabric with your waterproof material. It helps reduce the chance of cracking. Also, product such as RedGard needs to be applied at least 2 coats. This ensures all areas are covered with the product. After waterproofing the wall, the tiles can be installed with thinset, and then fill the gaps between the tiles with grout. And finally, seal the gaps between the floor and wall tiles using sealant. Oh, and don't forget, there's a small cover piece for your drain. Now let me talk about why do we need so many layers for the shower pan. First, remember the filler material between the tiles, known as grout? They are not always waterproof. Of course, there are waterproof grout, but most are not. Also, not all floor and wall tiles are waterproof. For example, natural materials like marble is porous, which allows water to seep its way through. Because we live on Earth and Earth has gravity, water will always find some way to seep downward. It's just a matter of time. Our only option is to ensure that the penetrating water can drain away properly rather than accumulating in some place where it's not supposed to. This is where the shower pan liner comes into play. Say the water that comes from the top goes through either your marble tile or your grout. The water will keep going down until it reaches the waterproof layer, and then the water follows the slope through the weep holes and down to the drain. This is exactly why the top mortar bed should not be coated with waterproof material. If the top bed is coated, the infiltrating water will accumulate in the thinset layer. Because there is no weep holes, water has nowhere to go. And over time, the water stuck in the thinset layer can lead to mold, or the tiles can detach from being soaked for a long time. So here you go. This is shower pan liner explained in 5 minutes. I hope you find this video helpful. Let me know your thoughts in the comments.